I think that teaching comes on multiple levels. So it's not enough just to be a good writer. It's not enough to just be a good scholar. It's not enough to be a good researcher. But can I take what I've written, what an expert would understand, and translate it, reinterpret it, so that I can inspire an 18-year-old to come up to me after class and say, so can you tell me more about that archive in Milan? Can you tell me a little bit more about, you know, World War II and fascism? Can you tell me a little bit more about popular culture and cowboys in Italy, right? I think that our job as educators is really to reach the student. And that means finding whatever hooks them, finding whatever makes them tick, finding whatever they're passionate about. And the only way to do that is to understand what you're passionate about. My hope is that I inspire them not to become historians, because not everyone will become a historian, but that they become citizens. They read a newspaper a little bit differently. They listen to the news a little bit differently. They question what they hear a little bit. They feel like they're actually part of a global movement, that they're actually connected, that what happens in Africa with the Ebola touches them at home in some way, that hunger in Africa is hunger in Lubbock, and that they can begin to make these connections. And that, I think, is my job as an educator, is to help them understand that they have tools. They have tools, they have compassion, and that those decisions are their own to make. My best moment is when I realize that the light bulb has turned on. When I see in my students' faces, they want me to keep going. They want to keep going on a topic. They want to keep talking about it. They want to keep hearing about it. They want to learn more about it. And I think that's the excitement that so often we miss now. We're so focused on touching, you know, checking off all of the items on the list, that we don't allow for passion to really explode, for engagement to really happen. We have to have the patience to let it nurture, to let it flower, to let it really seed, and to really let it grow.